to let me know. Should I stay or should I go?
Hi folks, Mike Schrampke with Larry Stovesand Equipment, America's largest selling coyote dealer and Tennessee's only five-paw premier dealer. Today I wanted, I mentioned in a video not too long ago that we were moving our Springfield location, and today I thought it'd be kind of cool to give you a some pictures of the before, and as we go along, I'll add some more. The Springfield location has been good to us. We sell a lot of tractors there. We've been there for 2 years, and it's just, quite honestly, too small. The building is too small. The property's too small. We started with just me, John, and Thomas up there, and now we have seven people, and it's tiny. Seven people sharing one bathroom. I've got Linda working in the kitchen. Samantha doesn't really have a desk. It's time to go. Found a property in Pleasant View, Tennessee. It's 6 miles away. In fact, it's closer to Interstate 24. It'll be even easier to get to. And I'd like to show you some stuff. It's a good-sized building, 10,500 square feet, 2.7 acres, and I'll be able to park as much as Coyote will send me. It's going to be cool. So let's take a look at the new property in Pleasant View, Tennessee. All right, folks, in the main entranceway of the store, it's set up, as you can see, with some pretty neat architecture that I liked, but I was outvoted. Samantha and John had different ideas of removing all this really nice looking stuff and that wall there and doing other stuff. So what's the plan on that?
It's going to be completely open. We're going to take out all of this all the way to the back. We're going to have a really nice roll-up door on the back. And then this will all be open up to the ceiling.
So this will be a showroom, and you know, like she said, all the way open, all, you know, corridor all the way down. And we can actually get a whole bunch of tractors and mowers in here. John had then thought of what to do with the walls to kind of add some a bit of a rustic look.
Yeah, we're going to do a corrugated galvanized steel on the wall all the way to the ceiling, kind of give it a little bit of a rustic look. It'll be on this wall over here that you can't see, all the way to the back, and have hopefully some monitors and signage and literature and everything on that wall for everybody to take a look at.
And the ceilings, what you can't see is it has a typical drop ceiling with acoustic tile and fluorescent lights, which
will go away.
Yeah, they're all going to go away. The ceilings then will be 15 feet high and painted black in an industrial type of a look with the tube type delivery of the air conditioning and heat. I'm assuming it would have been a lot cheaper not to do any of that, but it's it's going to look cool. My only request in this whole building was that at the end of this room, where there is a 14-foot roll-up door, I wanted a glass door. I thought it'd be cool to have sunlight and visibility all the way through to the back. And John is working hard to pee on my charcoal because he found the price for a glass door. How much?
$10,000.
$10,000 without installation. So he's now in charge of finding a door that's not $10,000. That's all I wanted. Of all the changes we're going to make here, that's all I wanted was a roll-up glass door in the back. So, you know, we'll see how that goes. You know, let's take a look around the rest of the store. We got some pretty cool footage, and, you know, see what you think. The service department is a special delight. Big shop, two 14-foot doors. The problem we had at the shop at Springfield, any of you that have been there, it was tiny. Guys that were repairing tractors or doing maintenance on tractors would be stumbling over the guys that we're filling the tires or adding a backhoe. It made for closeness, and everybody had to get along. And this is going to be amazing. This is just service and repair, maintenance, service, repair. We have an entirely a separate shop for the guys that do the final assembly, fill the tires, add valves, add a backhoe, do the options, install the options that folks are looking for, and I'll show you that. This room will be for final assembly. The technicians in here are the ones that would fill the tires, add secondary valves, add cruise control, loaders, whatever people want on the tractors. We'll have compressed air all throughout here and the main shop, and it'll just be nice. Typically, this is the loudest section with air wrenches and everything else, and it isolates it from everybody else, customers, and the main room for technicians. And this room is big. They can we figured they could work on as many as 8 tractors at a time in here. This will be cool. This room will be the parts department. It has a roll-up door in the back, very high ceilings, so lots of shelving. It'll have customer access from the front. Thomas's office, the service manager, parts manager, will be up front as well, so the customers will come in from the front side of the building, and then Thomas's office, and if Thomas needs to escort them out to the shop, this wall will have access. And that's a restroom. We're going to add a shower for the technicians. Sometimes something will go awry and they'll be blasted with hydraulic oil or rim guard tire fill. It'll just be nice to have a shower. All right, so that's it. I'll make some more videos as we go along. You're seeing it as we see it right now, and it's going to be fabulous. It's going to be we're spending $1 or $2 on it. We bought the building, but that's just the first part. Now we have to make it right for us, and it's going to be cool. Every year at the dealer meeting, Coyote has an award for the best renovation or the best looking new facility, and my wife told me that whatever we do, we will win it this time. So we're going to pull out all the stops. We'll keep you posted, and we'll show you some more. This is Mike Schrampke, Larry Stovesand Equipment in Murfreesboro, and right now in Springfield, soon to be Murfreesboro and Pleasant View, Tennessee, America's largest selling Coyote dealer and Tennessee's only 5-paw premier dealer. Please subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. Put some comments in. I respond to all. Thank you. Come on and let me know. Should I cool it or should I blow? Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay?